I want you to imagine you're on a walk. Think about how your foot rolls over the ground, how your arms and legs are swinging, how your body weight shifts from the left foot to your right foot and back again. Walking is this sophisticated orchestra of neurons and muscles, all firing in a coordinated fashion to make sure that we can reach our destination without falling. And what's most amazing about this process is we rarely think about any of it. Walking is what we might call automatic to most people, but not everyone. Traumatic brain injuries, like concussions, can significantly impact this process. 3 million Americans suffer a concussion every year, and the vast majority of them have balance and gait problems as a consequence. In fact, over 25% of individuals with a concussion report lasting problems in balance and dizziness over a year after their initial injury. My name is Peter Fino. I'm an associate professor of health and kinesiology at the University of Utah, and I've spent my career focused on understanding how humans maintain balance and avoid falling, and how to use that information to improve the balance and mobility of people with traumatic brain injuries like concussions. But my story begins with a slightly less noble pursuit: winning at sports. I grew up the youngest of seven siblings. Now, I love my siblings very much, and they've set an example for me to follow. But anyone who has siblings, especially if you're the youngest, you know that you spend decades being the smallest and the slowest. And generally, you have a disadvantage at everything because you never even get to pick the game that you play. But it was this competition that drove me to obsess over sports and how to become faster, better, and just generally beat my older brothers and sisters. Growing up, I played about every sport you can imagine, and I was convinced that I wanted to become a professional athlete. Now, obviously I didn't, and I learned that there was something else that I could go pro in. And I learned that thanks to Dr. Frank Zacco. Frank was one of my swim coaches at Case Western Reserve University, but he also had a PhD in biophysics. As a mechanical engineering major, I was learning how forces create acceleration and cause stress and strain in materials. Well, at the same time, as a swimmer, I was trying to accelerate my body through the water as fast as possible, reduce drag, and generate power off the blocks. Frank was the first person to connect these concepts for me. He described how changing my hand position in the water would allow me to pull with greater force and reduce stress and strain in my elbow. For the first time, he introduced me to the concept of human biomechanics, the application of mechanics and physics to the human body. I was hooked, and I wanted to learn more. I decided to pursue a PhD in mechanical engineering at Virginia Tech. There, I joined a gait biomechanics lab, where I learned how we can apply mechanics and mechanical systems to the human body. And I learned how walking is really just kind of a series of controlled falls where we're constantly catching ourselves with the next step. Around the same time, I also suffered, unfortunately, a series of concussions while playing soccer. I realized that my balance was a little bit off, and I became really obsessed with this question of how does a concussion affect balance and mobility. Now, I was an engineer, so I'm pretty sure I knew that there was this thing called a brain, but I didn't quite know how it worked, let alone how to fix it. So I pursued postdoctoral training at Oregon Health and Science University. Within the Balance Disorders Lab, I was co-mentored by Drs. Lori King, Faye Horak, and Martina Mancini. And I learned how we can pair physical therapy with emerging engineering technologies like wearable sensors to dramatically improve patient outcomes. Perhaps most importantly, I learned that making a clinical impact requires this type of interdisciplinary collaboration. With this in mind, I was ecstatic to join the University of Utah in 2018 and partner with Dr. Lee Dibble, professor and now chair in the Department of Physical Therapy and Athletic Training. Situated within the College of Health, which uniquely bridges both the academic main and health science campuses, I also realized that Utah has a much broader resource that is critical to my success: amazing people. Every day, I'm fortunate to collaborate with people all across campus, from engineering to neurology to psychology to athletics. Our approach starts with a fundamental understanding of the biomechanics and neural control of balance and locomotion. How do we walk throughout daily life? How do I walk on a rocky trail or navigate a crowded hallway? From these questions, we then applied digital health technologies like smartphones, wearable sensors, smart watches, and virtual reality. These give us a better understanding of what people do in their daily life and allow us to translate our laboratory-based assessments into clinical environments. Finally, we use both those pieces, both the mechanistic understanding and the emerging technologies, to improve our physical therapy interventions for people with balance problems. Now, most simply, balance is the ability to not fall over. But this process involves the integration of multiple different sensory systems. We combine our vision, our proprioception coming from our muscles and joints, and our vestibular system coming from our inner ear. And our brain combines this information to create some type of internal map or representation of where we are in space and where we are relative to our surroundings. Based on this internal map, our brain generates a series of motor commands that it sends to our muscles so that our muscles can actuate our limbs and hopefully prevent us from falling on our face. While we typically think about balance as standing still, we use this process in a variety of different activities, from standing to walking to recovering from a slip, trip, or stumble. This type of balance control is essential to our daily life. Unfortunately, our current clinical assessments of balance, especially after concussion, remain rather limited. These assessments, which focus on standing balance, don't tell us anything about what someone will do in the field, in combat, or what you or I will do once we leave this room. Back in 2018, when I joined the University of Utah, we became really focused on this question of how do we improve our clinical assessments of balance and make them more reflective of what someone actually needs to do in daily life. We specifically focused on this idea of reactive balance, how someone might respond after they get, a bump or a trip. They've initiated a fall, and how do they stop themselves from actually hitting the ground? Like my own personal story, this story begins with a partnership with athletics. We received initial funding from the Pac-12 to work with our University of Utah athletics program and our University of Utah athletes. We then expanded that program and our testing based on some subsequent funding from the National Institutes of Health. We found that after a concussion, some people have abnormal static balance or standing balance. Sure enough, our traditional clinical tests might pick those up and we might be able to treat those. But there's a whole other group of people that might have abnormal reactive balance. These people might have trouble recovering and might have higher rate of falls and be at an increased risk for musculoskeletal injuries like ACL tears. Unfortunately, our current clinical tests remain blind to everyone who's on the right-hand side of that screen. Based on this, we received follow-up funding from the Pac-12 to develop a smartphone application. So now our athletic trainers and our physicians can directly assess reactive balance, whether that's on the field or in the clinic, and get objective, instant results that they can use to manage their patient. Still, we don't really know what to do with these patients. There's no clinical guidelines on how to treat reactive balance problems in people with concussions. So that's why I'm excited that later this year we'll be starting a new multi-million dollar, multi-state grant that's in collaboration with OHSU and to specifically design and implement a targeted physical therapy intervention to improve reactive balance in people with concussion. Now, ultimately, my background in sports tells me that no success is just individual. It's always a team effort. And perhaps my biggest accomplishment and what I take the most pride in is working with the amazing students, postdocs, and staff, including our research coordinators, that I get to work with every day. Seeing them develop into the curious, creative, and collaborative scientists of the future is my highlight. Thank you.